So when looking to invest, the biggest challenge I always hear from first-time or potential investors or early rookie investors is, where do you find money to invest? A lot of that has to do with understanding how people are looking at investments. So for example, one of the first places you can look at is in your home, right? And now I know a lot of people are worried about taking money out of their house, but what you can do is you can refinance your house through what's called a home equity line of credit. You can pull some of that money out and you can use it for investments. And when I say use it for investments, I'm not talking about putting it into another property. I'm talking about using it to generate activity where you can go out and raise money. Because the biggest thing you want to do when looking for other money to invest is joint venture. So you're looking for people with money, you're raising capital, you're entertaining, or you're talking to what I call money partners. And what that means is you got to go out, you got to network with these people. You don't want to put a lot of your money in these investments, certainly not any kind of income investments. I hear all the time people, you know, they buy a property, they put so much down on it. After 2 or 3 years, the property's appreciated in value. They refinance it, they take the equity out, and then you do that again. The problem with that is you're really over-leveraged, right? You're always at the maximum leverage point of your investment, meaning it's the you never have more than 80% loan to value in your property. So what you want to do is you want to reduce all that problem, and you want to earn a lot of cash up front. And the way you do that is by going out and raising money. And that is where you find money to invest. I mean, there's other sources that you want to bring your investors into where they would go and they would qualify for a mortgage, or they would qualify for a home equity line of credit. They would give you the money, and then you take that money and go out and invest and do something like a fix and flip, or like a lease option or sandwich lease option, because you want to leverage their money. They're happy as passive investors making, you know, 7, 8, 9, 10%. You, as an active investor, want to make a lot more money than that, and so you want access to that cash. Access to money is a lot more important than the cost of money, assuming, of course, that the business model works, meaning that, you know, you're going to actually make a return on your investment. And by leveraging and by using other people's monies, you're going to get a higher return over the long run in a sense that you're going to be making more deals, right? 50% of 100 deals is a lot better than 100% of 3 or 4 deals. And that's really how beginner investors get sort of stalled, as they try to do all those financing, all those deals on their own, and they're afraid to give up any of the profit to another investor. Okay, so this is how you would structure going out and getting money for your investments.